नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्तिमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the living and practicing Hindus from all over the world. I welcome all the visitors, viewers, Sarvanya Peeta Kartas, Yajamans, Manifestors, Sarvaparityagis, Shrimahans, Mahans, Kotaris, Tanedars. Everyone sitting with us all over the world through Kailasa TV, Kailasas Nityananda TV, Kailasas Hinduism Now TV, Kailasas Enlighten App. I welcome all of you with my love and respect. Today, 11th day of the Chittirai Brahmotsavam celebration in all the Sarvanya Peetas all over the world. Parashakti Meenakshi is gracing in Sarva Alankara and Sundareshwara Paramashiva is gracing in Sarva Alankara and Swarnarishabha Vahana. Let's first receive their grace, offer our worship, then enter into the satsang.
आदिशक्त्यावृताम् येलागन्धिसुकुन्दाम् द्विजनाम् हेमाङ्कृताम् वामेकराम् सुशयनयाम् दक्षेकरेन्द्राम् अमाभान्दुचारुणाम् सुमीने क्षाम ओम धूर्वसि धूर्वतयो अस्मान् धूर्वयं वयं धूर्वां मस्तं हृगस्थितमं पप्रितं मञ्जुष्टमं देवहूतमम तमस्वार्मित्रस्य स्वात्मा भेर्मा सन्निक्षापमात्रम् ओम श्री नित्या मीनाक्षिदेवी महाधुघ्रापयामी उद्दीप्य स्वयदोपघ्नं निरृत्य मम कृश्च मह्यमावहति जीवन मानो हितुं श्री जामश्वं पुरुषं जगत् तदग्नागहि श्रिया पाप ओं श्री नित्यानन्दी मीनाक्षिदेवी महानदीदीपं सन्दर्शयाम् अथ नैवेद्यम् ओं मधुवात्तार तायन्ति सिन्धवः मीर्न सन्तोषी मधुनक्तमुत्तोषपार्थिवगुम्रजः मधुद्यौरस्पिता मधुमान् वनस्पतिर्मधुमागम् पूर्यः माध्वीर्गावोऽप्तुनः मधु 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 ॐ श्रीनित्यानन्देश्च श्री पद्मिनाक्षी देवी महानि नैवेद्यानि निवेदयामि ॐ सर्वस्याप्यै सर्वचित्त्यै सर्वमेव तेनाप् ॐ बह्वश्वायै बह्वजकायै बह्वतिलायै बहुहिरण्यायै बहुहस्तिकायै बहुत्साषायै रैमत्ये बहुरायकोषायै राजास्तु ॐ श्री नित्यानन्देश्वरी पराशक्ति मीनाक्षिदेवी नमः सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानन्द परमशिवाय नमः सर्वोपचारार्थे सर्वापराध क्षमाभये समस्तमङ्गलप्राप्त्यर्थ महामङ्गलनीरजनं सन्ध्यामि रक्षान्धातयामि क्षालम्बितवाद्रितपदम् कृष्णं मृगचाभयं टंकं वरं ये विनया वामके निद्रितान्यपदया देव्या मध्यतः स्कंदे नकरद्वये सो कुमारेशं भजे अथद्रूपम् ओम पूर्वतयो अस्मान् धूर्पानामचितमम्ब प्रीतमञ्जुष्टतमभूत मम हृत्तमसि हृगम् स्वमाह्वार्मिचक्षुषा प्रेक्षेमा भैर्मात्वा हिगंसिषम् नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिव सोमस्वामिने नमो नमः धूपमामि ईप्यस्वजात वेदोपघ्नन् पशुकिश्च मह्यमावह जीवन च दिशो दिश मानो हिगुंसी जात वेदामश्वं पुरुषं जगत् अभिलग्न आगहि श्रिया नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिव सोमस्वामिने नमो नमः एकः रतिः दर्शयामि एद्यम् ॐ अमृते अमृतवर्षिणी स्वाह ओम श्री नित्यानंदे शिव सोम सुंदरेश्वर नमः नाना विधानि नैद्यानि निवेदयामि धनीराजन ओम सोमो वाये राज्यमादत्ते आसन राज्यो वासेन यजते देवतानि हवीगं शिभवन एतावन्तो वै देशवाः तयेव सवान् प्रयच्छन्ति एनं पुनः सुवन्ते राजा भवति तमहे वाग्विशुद्धान शिवः प्रचोदया ॐ श्री नित्यानन्देश्वर सोमसुन्दरेश्वर स्वामिने स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्या शिवाय नमः सर्वोपचार सर्वापराध क्षमापना अर्थे मंगलप्राप्त्यर्थे च मदनीराजनं सन्दर्शयामि रक्षां धारयामि
Paramashiva Smasi from Kailas. Listen. Ahimsa Paramo Dharmaha. The ultimate cosmic law. Dharma means cosmic law. The ultimate cosmic law. Ahimsa, non-violence, is the most powerful, best strategy even to stop the Hindu Holocaust. Listen, I talk after thoroughly tuning myself to Paramashiva. Literally, Paramashiva is uttering every word I am uttering. Even the full stop, comma, pass, everything is directly His. Including the body language, everything is His. He is just using this muscle memory, bioenergy to manifest and do what He wants to do. So please understand, I am very responsible for what I am talking. Let me first make clear explanations. Let me first make you all understand how I adopt ahimsa, non-violence, for relationship with me and relationship with my guru, relationship with my first team, relationship with my sangha, relationship with my disciples and devotees, relationship with practicing Hindus, relationship with the whole universe, relationship with the whole humanity, relationship with everything. I'll explain step by step how I adopt. Krishna says beautifully in the Gita, if you know how I function, you will become enlightened. I tell you, Krishna is the greatest strategizer based on this Paramadharma Ahimsa. Fools and stupids, anti-Hindus are those who claim Krishna made Mahabharata war. No! Understand? Krishna personally went to negotiate peace. And he was abused, and Krishna knows he will be abused, he may be abused when he goes for negotiating peace, but still he took the risk. Not only abused, there was a murder attempt on Krishna. There was a murder attempt. Krishna followed all the rules of an ambassador, means coming without any protection, weapon, without any security guard, army, nothing. Just Nirayudha Bani, he came. And this bloody Gaurava fellows and Duryodhana, due to his extreme delusion, he orders Krishna's arrest. And then the whole earth shakes. And Bhuma Devi kicked him out of his throne. He was thrown out of his throne. THROWN. Thrown out of his throne. THRONE. That time itself, Bhuma Devi decided this fellow, this Duryodhana, should not win in the war. See, arresting Krishna, not only not right as per the country law, it's atrocious as per even the cosmic law. Both the way. And originally Hindu kingdoms are supposed to run by cosmic law. It is cosmic law which runs the Hindu countries. Cosmic law itself is adopted as a country's law. That's the way the constitutions are drawn. I'm telling you guys. When I read more and more the Hindu constitutions and Hindu criminal procedure codes, what a civilization. I'm just every day falling in love with Manu, Bharadwaja, Yanyavalgya, I tell you guys, I will at least keep all this alive in one place where the future by the grace of Paramashiva and Parashakti, because they are blessing me with the power manifestation signs, more and more with the power manifestation signs, I am going to inspire many countries' decision makers, judges, administrators to study Hindu scriptures. Just for that, I am collecting and organizing everything. When a judge in a developed country is surprised about the power manifestation signs of Hinduism, I will make sure and support him to understand in the judicial system how life positivity is. Anyhow, all these are my future plans and vision. Let me now stick to this one subject, how the non-violence, ahimsa, can be the strategy to stop the Hindu Holocaust. First thing, understand. Even though Krishna inspired Arjuna to wage the war, his core being is non-violent. Let me correct the statement, listen. Even though Krishna inspired Arjuna to wage the war, he was never a violent person. He is absolutely established in non-violence. Ahimsa paramo dharmaha. Understand? Understand this one example. Fools think I am wearing gold, only I know I am wearing Rudraksha. Fools think I am wearing gold, but intelligent people understand I am wearing Rudraksha. Rudraksha is the core I am wearing. Krishna is absolutely non-violent to his core. He wants the humanity to be saved. But those days, the foolish, when he was in the body, the foolish human beings who did not listen made the Mahabharata war and the destruction. Even at that situation, Krishna made sure that minimum damage is done and at least humanity is spared. Listen. Step by step, understand. I'll put the whole zigzag puzzle. I'm making different statements. Now I'll connect all of them and understand this. Core of me are Krishna. Our core, which does the strategy. Is pure compassion, non-violence, ahimsa. Janma karma chame divyam evam yotive एवं योवेति तत्वतः त्यक्त्वा देहं पुनर्जन्मनैति मामेति सोऽर्जुन. अंडरस्टैंड. I will expand on this verse when I am continuing with the whole satsang. Now just listen to the verse. Janma karma chame divyam evam yoveti tatvatah tyaktva deham punarjanmana iti mameti sorjuna. Punarjanmana iti na iti na iti mameti sorjuna. Now listen, let me eat. Fundamental, if you understand the true nature of my existence and the activities, you will become liberated and you will not be bound by the birth death cycle. One who knows the true nature of my happening and activities does not, upon leaving the body, take his birth again in this material world and attains my eternal abode. Listen, I'll reveal the secret to go to Kailasa once for all and be liberated. I'll give you the real secret. Listen. All violence is delusion. Please listen. 99.9999% of the material out of which you are made and I am made. Listen. 99.9999% of you and 99.9999% of me, both not only same stuff, they also know each other as the same stuff. Hey, listen, I'm talking to each one of you. Peter, listen, this is what I did when you asked for healing. I just told me in you, hey, get well. You got well. Listen, each one of you, I am talking to each one of you. Listen, Rani Ayya, you need to understand what I am talking. Only then you can do the transcription properly. See, all my Balasans, listen. 99.999999% of the stuff out of which you are made, and 99.999999% of the stuff out of which I am made, both are one and the same. Listen to the second statement, that both material know that they are one and the same. That 0.0000001%. That only is the little arrogance, anger, makes you and me feel separate inside you. I call it delusion. I tell you, the worst delusion, greatest delusion, illusion on in the universe is feeling of separation. At one day, quantum physics and science will catch up with what I am declaring. That will be the greatest revelation for humanity. As on now, the trust level between the humanity decision makers and me may be very less because they do not know me or whatever. So what I am declaring now, they may not take it seriously, but at some point, people whom they trust, those scientists or quantum physicists or whoever, they may come to the same conclusion which I am declaring. They will come. Humanity has to come to this conclusion which I am declaring now, because humanity need to be saved, no other way. So humanity has to come to this conclusion. It will come to this conclusion. Listen, 99.99999% of the stuff out of which you are made, I am made, all of us are made, that stuff is same. And the most important thing is, not only it is same, it knows we are all same. So 0.1%, I won't even say 0.1%, 0.00001%, that only makes you feel you are separate from the universe. Anger and arrogance. Listen carefully. That is why I am telling, feeling separated is the most stupidest and Worst delusion. It is from the feeling separated stems violence. Violence is rooted in feeling separated. Hey, all my Gurukul kids, listen. You need to listen. You need to now remember again. I am sitting with you all alone. Maybe in Kailash courtyard, some of the other kids, all the Balasins are there doing power manifestation. During power manifestation, I give precise powerful cognitions. Not one word extra, one word less. Power manifestation needs certain intense, integrated atmosphere. Even once if you cheat that vatavarana, that energy field is disrespected, and it takes a lot of time to heal that energy field again. So listen, it's with extreme love and compassion I am telling you the secrets. Secrets of my success. And these secrets will make you successful. Never ever get frustrated about life. Never ever get angry about life. Never ever get violent about life. If you cut and check me inside, there will be 0% violence. Not even one iota of violence. That is the secret of my success. Now you should listen. All my kids, listen. I am sitting with you with my one hand on your shoulder and telling, Kane, idu parama ragasyam da, nalla ketuko. The material, the metal, core stuff out of which you are made, I am made, this universe is made, Paramashiva is made, that material is same. And great news is this material knows that we are all same. It is not that you need to build this enlightenment step by step. No. The material, which is you, your body, your mind, your core cognition, your individual identity, and what you call as your body, your mind, your privacy, your secrecy, your all the things. Whatever you call as you, closer to you, my mother, my father, my daughter, my sister, my son, my husband, my whatever, my friend, my beloved, my soulmate, or me. All this is made of certain stuff. That stuff and the Paramashiva, the stuff out of which Paramashiva is made, and the stuff out of which I am made, all of us are made. That stuff, that material is same. This is the good news. The greatest news is that material knows each other that it is same. This I want all my kids to meditate today. I tell you this. I give boon to all my balasans. Meditate on this truth. Whatever power you want to manifest, tell me. Now itself I bless you, you will manifest that. Because if you meditate on this one truth, you become me. You became me. Hey, Shivayoga, listen. I am so happy you are attached to Bhagavad Gita and you are reading it. Now understand, this is the essence of Bhagavad Gita. I am talking to you personally. You and me are one and the same. And you know that we both are one and the same. That is the great news. Not just good news, great news. And all of you should understand. See, what I am talking to my kids is the most important secret strategy. This is like how you should know the funny thing. Top people who administer, promote vaccines, don't vaccinate their kids. I don't want to get into that anymore. Not leave it, forget about that subject. The top people always have certain secrets only for them and for their family. Listen, whatever they do with their family is the right, the most right and secret strategy. I am talking this to my kids, means this is the most secret but right strategy. Raja Vidya, Raja Guhyam. Royal knowledge, royal secret. Feeling separation should be handled with the tool of completion, not supported by your arrogance. When you feel separated, do not try to support your thought currents with arrogance. No. Try to deal yourself with completion. I tell you. I am telling you some of the basic truths. Listen. Some of the basic truths. This really happened. I bowed down to our earlier Sannidhanams who are now shown in the backdrop. Actually 88, 89, 90, all our Paramaguru Sannidhanams, our Acharyas, our earlier Sannidhanams are now shown as a background. I think already in all our Saranya Pita we have kept the photographs of them. Listen. Listen carefully. Inside, if you decide no violence, no separation, if there is a separation feeling, no question of encouraging that feeling. You are dreaming as if a tiger is chasing you and you are screaming, hey, somebody give me my revolver, please somebody give me a weapon, please somebody give me a rifle, I have to kill this tiger and save myself. Unless your wife is really, really angry with you, she will not give you the revolver. Because if you get the revolver in the deluded state, you will surely kill yourself or the people around you, not the tiger you are seeing in the dream and in your delusion. Listen. When you are deluded and screaming like that, all you need is somebody just pouring a cup of water on you or slapping you for you to wake up. You need alarm, not revolver. Understand? The inside you healing and understanding the core delusion is separation. From that core delusion starts all violence and violent strategy. If you understand this, you will become non-violent for your whole life. You will never have birth and death. You will not have a strong violence which will pull you down again to this planet Earth. See, the greatest thing is, factually, so many murder attempts happened on me. Factually, so many people tried to kill me. So much of abuse, harassment, injustice done. But I decided not to hurt myself because they are trying to hurt me. Understand? They are trying to hurt you. Your enemies attacking you is violence. But if you become violent, you are hurting yourself also. So now your enemy got one more person, which is you supporting him to destroy you. Listen to this equation carefully. Factually, there were so many murder attempts on me. Lawfare, character assassination, murder attempts, assassination attempts, literally destroying my whole hard work and sangha, making me illegitimate. Everything happened in factual level. The evidences are there all over the internet. But in my core inner space, I did not allow the reaction of violence. Because of my clarity, separation is delusion. I started operating from the cosmic logic, cosmic law, dharma. Dharmo rakshati rakshitaha. If you protect dharma, dharma will protect you. Dharmo rakshati rakshitaha. Listen. I operate from the cosmic law, cosmic logic. I never became violent. I only started analyzing what should I do now to fulfill my mission. What is my mission? To bring all the great things from Kailasa, Paramashiva's grace first. And all the great things like a state of Paramashiva, space of Paramashiva, powers of Paramashiva, being of Paramashiva, super consciousness of Paramashiva, Kailasa of Paramashiva, all the great science, technology, methodology, knowledge, all those great things, bringing all of it and sharing it with the world. Understand? Then Skandamata starts talking, starts understanding, communicating. This is the first truth I will teach her. Hey, you and me are one and the same. You and everyone around you are one and the same. You, your mom, your dad, your sisters and this universe and me and Paramashiva, all these are one and the same. This is the first gift I will give it to her as her guru. My favorite papa. To my favorite papa, this is the first gift I will give because this is the most valuable gift I got from my guru, Paramashiva, Arunagiri Yogishwara. Listen. I'll give you tons of evidences from the earlier researches done, and the soon whole humanity will come to the conclusion which I am declaring now. I am declaring it because I myself know, and the Shastras approve what I am declaring and my experience. My Atma Pramana, Shastra Pramana and Apta Pramana, all these are absolutely in alignment. The great Shastra's declaration and great Master's declaration and my own experience, all these three are matching. That is why I am sharing it with all of you. Listen. When you understand Ahimsa Paramo Dharmaha, At every situation, you only respond life positive. You don't react. You don't become, justice need to be done. They did that to me. I will see what I will do. That's a cheap middle class mediocre mentality. Stop. They arrested me illegally. It was a assassination attempt, persecution attempt. All world knows. There are tons of evidence. Na bhuto na bhavishyati means neither before nor after in whole Indian legal history, the Indian history, any FIR filed without a victim. Because I never raped anybody, how will you find a victim? Without even cooking up a false victim, they filed the FIR because they don't have time to file, to cook up the false victim. They need some person, they could not find. Na bhuto na bhavishyati, neither before April 4th, 2010 of Indian history and nor after April 10th, 2010 of Indian history, sorry, maybe March 4th. Neither before the March 4th, 2010 of the Indian history nor after the March 4th, 2010 of the Indian history, there was ever FIR filed without a victim for the rape charge. Foolish, stupid dogs destroyed the respect for Indian legal system. This corrupt police officers from Tamil Nadu police. I don't know the name of that person who signed that FIR. I'll get that name. This fellow has brought such a shame on the whole Tamil Nadu police and whole Indian police. You'll be a black mark, black on the whole Indian legal system. Because there is something called natural justice. Without anybody is dying, you file a murder charge. Without anybody raped, you file a rape charge. An arrest. Yes. All these are factual. Injustice done to me. My lawyer suggested, Swamiji, we should file for malicious prosecution. Yes. What will happen? To attend that case, I have to go to the court and come. By that time, the Tamil Nadu police is very intelligent and powerful. They will kill me. Or even if I manage to survive somehow, when will the justice be served? 25 years. By that time, I'll be, I don't know, 60. At what age they attack me? I think 2010 if they attack me means. Then I was around 30, little more than 30. 78 born. I must be 32. Around 32. So when the justice comes, it will be at least 60. 25. Sometimes even more than that. I may be around 60. So you want me to waste my whole life on this? That's the most stupid, mediocre, middle class mentality. Not that what they did is right, but I operate from cosmic logic. Hey, I am here to deliver Paramashiva Jnana and Paramashiva Vijnana. This Dravish gang, which is attacking me, which was attempting to assassinate and eliminate me, and that gang, they are only aim is that I should not deliver what I brought from Kailasa. They don't have any other personal hatred on me. Because I am nowhere related to them. I never even spoke one word criticizing them. Forget about it. I never even bother about them. Actually, don't even know them. Till they attacked me, I don't even know their names. So, there is no personal enmity. They tried to grab some of our properties, is true, but just for the property, I don't think they will try to kill, because they grab the property of the whole country. If they have to kill everyone from whom they have to grab the property, then nobody will be alive in Tamil Nadu. So that may be one reason that I did not cooperate with them for them grabbing my property, Sangha's property. That is one. But the persistent murder attempts, assassination attempts, is more ideological. They do not want me to do the real spiritual work. And you need to understand, even if I win the war in the end, they would have wasted my whole life. Understand? Just by getting into the war, I would have lost my whole life. The purpose for which I came would not have been fulfilled. That is why I am telling you, Ahimsa Paramo Dharmaha. See, one thing, inside me there was so much of healing, completion, understanding about Ahimsa Paramo Dharmaha. Ahimsa is ultimate cosmic law. Because of that, I never got agitated, even though factually so much of injustice is done to me. I never reacted or responded. Just now we got the information. One person's name, Inspector Madhiyazhagan, is the one who signed the FIR. This fellow has brought up irreparable shame on the whole Tamil Nadu police and Indian police and the whole Indian legal system, CRPC system. Na bhuto na bhavishyati. Neither before the April 4th, 2010, nor after the April 4th, 2010, ever there is an FIR filed on anyone on rape charge without anybody getting raped, without any victim. See, you call somebody as a victim and then court says, no evidence, and then acute, that and all is happening. That is regular happening. Some cases get convicted, some cases get acquitted, that is different. But without even a victim filing an FIR and arresting, shows very clearly it's a murder attempt, assassination attempt, attempt to kill me. And they are using prosecution as a very cunning way of legitimizing their attempt to kill me. That's all. So listen now. Factually, so much of injustice is done on me, no doubt. But Paramashiva has given me the strength at the age of 10. Arunagiri Ishra has beautifully drilled into me my mission, what I am supposed to do. That was so alive in me. I did not get deluded by this ... demons and devils. I tell you, if I got into the war with them, with Paramashiva's grace and the powers he has given and the protection of Kalabhairava, I would have won. But when? I would have won, W-O-N. But when? W-H-E-N. By then my life would have gone. I will not be able to enlighten all of you. I'll be so busy there. Is that the purpose of my life? I tell you, if you don't react, don't get agitated with violence inside, you will be so aligned to your purpose, you will be productive for yourself. Feeling productive for yourself is the ultimate completion you need when you need to die, when you need to leave the body. You see, when I need to leave the body, I am absolutely clear. I have feeling that productive for myself, my goal. What I want as a life, I am productive to myself and my purpose, my strategy. That is what is fulfillment, Purnatva, completion. If you carry that when you are leaving the body, you will be enlightened, you will be liberated. You don't need to come back once more. I have absolutely that asset. And I want all my kids especially to learn this, understand. This is what Arunagiri Ishwara drilled inside my core when I was 10-year-old boy. One thing, my gurus are such honest people. All my love I poured on them, they used it to make me enlightened. And I tell all my disciples, I will be absolutely integrated to you. All the love you pour on me, I'll be absolutely integrated to you and make you enlightened. I'll give the best to you all. I will neither cheat nor exploit, and I'll give all the best things of the universe to all of you. It's my commitment, because that's the way my guru has treated me. See, how your mother-in-law treated you, you will treat your daughter-in-law same way. It's a chakra, cycle. How my guru treated me, I will treat you all in the same way. My gurus were absolutely integrated to me. So I commit with you guys, I will be absolutely integrated to you. And I tell all my kids, whatever tantrum you throw, I will never hate you. Because my gurus have never hated me. And it's not that I did not throw tantrum with my gurus. I have done so much. That karma only is coming to me now. That's all of your tantrum. But that is okay. How they loved me. Even if I threw all tantrums and never gave up on me, I promise and commit with you guys. I commit with you guys. I'll behave the same way my gurus behaved with me and took care of me. I'll not give up on you guys, and I'll not hate you guys. I'll never ever hate you guys. I'll not give up. Even if you guys leave, I'll wait for you to come back. I'll never hate. I tell you, at the age of 10, the kind of the love and trust I had with Arunagiri Yogeshwara, if he wanted, he could have made me a terrorist. Nothing would have stopped. Because I would have just died or did anything for him. If he wanted to make me a suicide bomber, he could have easily done it. He doesn't need to even struggle to convince me, because I was in love with him so much. But he gave me the best of the universe. I tell you guys, my kids, I will also give you the best my guru gave me. Ahimsa paramo dharmaha. Non-violence is the cosmic ultimate truth and law. Start applying that inside your relationship with yourself. That is where the grounding with the cosmos happens. grounding in the cosmos happens. See how to build the muscles. You do all working out, you do all jimnaka, jim, jump, jump, jim, all that. Same way, to build consciousness, grind yourself with absolute completion. You will gain so much power and powerfulness inside. From that powerfulness, you will know the goal of life and you will strategize. See, if I got into the fight with them, with this Dravish gang which was trying to kill me, whether I win the war or lose the war, I am the loser. Not getting into the war with them and moving in such a way that I continue to do my work, what I need to contribute to the world creatively, is the most successful right strategy. This I am able to do because my nerves were not reacting out of anger and violence and pushing me, forcing me to fight with them. I'm so thankful to Arunagiri Yogeshwara and the vegetarian body he created for me. The only non-vegetarian got into my blood. I should not even say non-vegetarian. The only once the blood went into my system is Arunagiri Yogeshwara's blood. Once some small wound on his finger happened. Usually the kids, that's the way we are taught in the school. The first aid is putting the saliva. And if your finger is cut, you have to put it in the mouth and stop the bleeding first. So I just did that. And his blood went inside the body. Other than that, no other blood has gone inside my body and absolute non-violent. So happy for the non-violent, stable, powerful nervous system Paramashiva has gifted to me. Because if you are agitated inside about this so-called justice, injustice, fact-based justice and injustice, your whole life is gone. Whole life is gone. You can see the sweetness and joy in my eyes before 2010 and now same. After 10 years of relentless persecution, unable to rest even one night peacefully, still my nervous system is not shattered. Could not, will never be shattered. That's the truth. Anybody else with so much of injustice done to them factually would have become violent. At least for self-defense. I made it very clear as my strategy. I will find a place where I can sit non-violent, peaceful way and contribute what I need to contribute to the world. This is the first greatest success because of non-violence as a strategy I adopted within me and with society. I wanted every level, all my disciples to understand how non-violence has saved me. Made me productive. made me contribute what I need to contribute to the world. See, I am not even going to be violent to declare non-violence is the only successful strategy. See that I don't want to make even that as one more violence. Forget about it. I am telling how I adopted non-violence from my Guru Parampara and how that has helped me in every level to deal with the most corrupt, worst terrorist gang on the planet Earth. You see the track record of the Dravish gang, the number of murders they committed, but with never ever getting accused. They are extremely criminals. They are such criminals the world will never know they are criminals. That kind of a, the Don Mafia gang, that kind of criminals. Escaping from them, the only person, you see, like the only FIR filed on somebody with a rape charge without a victim is me. Same way, the only person escaped from them is me. Just Paramashiva's grace and Kalabhairava's protection. Listen carefully. First of all, understand the so-called justice, injustice, all this belongs to binary logic of this world. Ahimsa paramo dharma, non-violence is the ultimate cosmic law. Is the cosmic law. It's from multidimensional logic of cosmos. Listen. I'll give you more deeper secret. A person who does not have reactions will have more time in the inner space to be more productive and more active and more workaholic. People ask me, seeing a Swamiji, last only few years you worked in your public life, how come you did so much humongous work? Especially people who see the pages that Sri Kailasa Uniting Nations for Yoga. I think the Sri Kailasa Uniting Nations for Yoga is the best page. Blessings to Ma Yoga and our team. My real daughter, Ma Yoga and our team. Blessings to the team. Amazing page. When people see all those pages and humongous work we have done, they ask me, how? So much work has been done. Listen, when you don't have reaction, when you are non-violent, you have so much time available for you. You are actually, literally, your time expands. Your time expands. It's a truth I'm telling you. I won't lie. I will not cheat. Listen, whatever my gurus gave me, I will give you. It is like a, I will let you eat from my plate. Actually, this is the way I am going to bring up Skanda Mata. It will be only my plate. How I eat? From same plate only, she will pick up and eat. That's what I want. In a dining table, she will be sitting on the table. I will sit in the chair and I will have a plate and I I usually eat with both hands, sometimes in right hand, sometimes with the left hand. And I'll put one handful to her also. She can pick up whatever she wants from my plate and eat. When you and me are eating from same plate, will I compromise on the quality of the food? No. Same way, this truth I am sharing with you is you and me eating from the same plate. I will not compromise on the quality of this truth. Listen. We often believe that exacting revenge is a form of emotional release and that getting retribution will help us feel better. Especially this modern day cinema, entertainment industry, cult brainwashes you. The act of revenge as a way of gaining closure after a wrong is done. No! I tell you the truth. Revenge has the opposite effect. Revenge is like a korangu surinjikra mari. Ari padangadu. In Tamil, they say that monkey feeling itching and scratching itself is never going to settle down. Till that monkey dies, it will not settle down because it will create a wound. And it will not keep quiet with that wound. That same wound, it will scratch more and more. And it will be more infection. Finally, the monkey will die. Korangu sorinjikittadum nama violence la vidaradum onnu. Understand? Mass media, cult, entertainment industry, TV and cinema, cult is brainwashing you, telling that revenge is heroism, violence is heroism. No, it is not. Non-violence is heroism. Absolute non-violence strategy. I have the total defamatory telecast time in number of days. I just wanted to share with you guys. Swarna TV has done 160 days. Samaya TV 120 days. Means it's like a 24 hours if you run the hate speech material on me. How many days? 1400 hours in just 4 years, the hate speech, poison dumped on me. Anybody else would have had a nervous breakdown and by now dead. Not only I am not dead and I am not having any nervous breakdown, I am paru enna paru. என் அழக பாரு ஜிங்கு ஜிங்கு. இட்ஸ் ஆல் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் பரமசிவாஸ் கிரேஸ், காலபைரவாஸ் ப்ரொடெக்ஷன். Strong, powerful cognitions my Guru Arunagiri Yogeshwara gave me. Remember this. We both are eating from same plate. I will not compromise on the quality of the food. You are all like Skandamata only for me. This is the way I want to bring up Skandamata. This is the way I will bring up. Soon you will see the photographs. You will be sitting on the dining table and I will be sitting on the chair. And from the same plate, I will be eating and she will also be eating. So when we both eat from same plate, we will not compromise the quality of the food. Same way, this satyas, these truths I am sharing, we both are eating from same plate. I will not compromise on the quality of the truth. I want all of you to watch one documentary. I am projecting a link. American documentary, how you are being controlled by media and entertainment cult. I want you to watch the link I am posting. Please watch. I think I have lot to tell you guys about the Raja Vidya Raja Guhyam, royal secret, royal knowledge. See, just imagine, Skandamata, my papa is sitting on the dining table, and I am sitting on the chair in the dining table, and we have one plate, and I am eating from that plate, and papa is also eating from that plate. Neither I will compromise the quality of food, nor I will compromise the truths I am talking to her during eating. Because that's the most sweetest moment, the right ultimate truths need to be shared. At those moments, the ultimate truths which I will share with her, I am sharing with all of you now. Imagine, visualize, we are all, each one of you are sitting with me alone, personally, individually. I am in your room, in your Nityananda Sabha. We both are sitting and eating from same plate. Whenever I am feeling relaxed and whenever I feel nobody is watching me, I eat with the left hand. Because I don't have that left-right problem. I sometimes eat with right hand, sometimes eat with left hand. I don't have that problem. So just visualize, we both are sitting. I'm eating with my left hand and you are also eating from the same plate. Once in a while, I give you also one handful. At this moment, how I will not compromise on the quality of the food, same way I will not compromise on the sweet truths I am sharing with you. Understand? Both are too important. The food we share and the truth we share is too important. That is why I am telling you. I don't have too many arguments, logic, binary logic to prove to you. But I will tell you step by step the cosmic logic and the truth. Ahimsa paramo dharmaha. Non-violence is the ultimate strategy for the success of life. Understand? Frustration, anger, guilt, feeling ashamed or revenge, all these action reactions, destroys your life, takes it away from you. you will be controlled and manipulated through those emotions. Listen. Injustice is done to me, no doubt. I am not saying it is not fact. It is a fact. Factually, so much injustice is done to me. But external facts should not mold your life's reality. Liberate yourself from the external facts. Let your life's reality not be impacted by the external fact. Then you are a leader. Person whose life is not impacted, affected by the external facts is leader. I did not allow my reality to be molded by Dravish demons, Yashaktis. Anti-Hindu terrorists and anti-Guru Hindu mafias. I did not allow these two gangs to mold my reality, to interfere in my reality, even though the facts they did, they created. You see, they attacking me is a fact. They really tried their best to mold my reality, but I did not allow. I remained as leader, Lord of my life, Atmeshwara. I remained as Ishwara for my soul and my life, and I remained as leader for myself because of non-violence. Not getting agitated, reacting violently and responding violently to them. Loose pasangala, Samiyar nenachingalada, Samiyar illada, Samida, Samiyar anda, eduthu poradi unga valaiyila sikki irpanda. அழிஞ்சோ அல்ல ஜெயிச்சோ ரெண்டா இருந்தாலும் உங்க வலையில சிக்கி இருந்தா லைஃப் முடிஞ்சு போயிருக்கு மேடா. உங்க வலையில சிக்காம தப்பிச்சதுலதான் நீங்க புரிஞ்சுக்கணும்டா. சாமியார் இல்லடா, சாமிடா. All of you understand. Not only I did not react, get agitated and do any violent reaction towards this Dravish gang, never once I even turned to my Guru Arunagiri Yogeshwara and said, Swamiji, why is this happening to me? Never. And I can't even think of it. When I turn to him, I only have a wide smile. And everything is the best he has done, he has given, he is giving, he will give. I know for sure. It is extreme wild, raw, intense, intimate, sweet, passionate, life positive oneness with him. I can't even think of questioning him, why is this being done to me? Why is this happening to me? After you being a guru of me, after you brought me up, and you gave me so much love, energy, power, support. You did everything to me. You are my everything. Why is this happening to me? அப்பா அந்த ஒரு சாபம் மட்டும் வேணாமடாடி. குரு சாபங்கிறது வேற ஒண்ணும் இல்ல, குருவை கேள்வி கேட்கறது தான் குரு சாபம். குரு சபிக்கிறது குரு சாபம் இல்ல, குருவை கேள்வி கேட்கறது தான் குரு சாபம். குரு சாபம் இஸ் நாட் குரு கர்சிங் யூ. You doubting the Guru or questioning the Guru is the Guru, the Guru Sabam. I tell you, in every level, non-violence as a strategy, because you see, non-violence makes you realize more and more oneness. It strengthens the oneness. Oneness strengthens the non-violence and non-violence strengthens the oneness. You need to understand the context. Only then you will understand how this non-violence can be a successful strategy. If you miss one or two components and do it out of wrong context, it will become a mess. It will become a laziness and non-involvement. See, laziness and non-involvement is not non-violence. Don't use non-violence brand and tag to justify your non-involvement and laziness. No. That's what Arjuna was trying to do in the Arjuna Vishada Yoga. He was telling Krishna, oh, why should I kill people? Why should I kill people? Let me go away and become a sannyasi. Dubukke. This fellow, when he went to do tapas in the forest also, he got married to a girl. Every time this fellow goes for tapas, whether he brings boons or not, he brings girls. All right. No disrespect to Arjuna. He is incarnation of Nara and Narayana. So no disrespect to Arjuna. Non-violence should not be misconstrued or should not be used to portray your non-involvement and laziness, tiredness and boredom. No. I'll continue. I think I'll let you all digest today this stuff and internalize. Then I'll explain step by step how the non-violence can be the ultimate and best strategy for to stop Hindu Holocaust. And how in the past we missed applying the non-violence from right context and applied in wrong context, where we should apply how, all that detailing I will get into in further satsangs. Now with this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living by the Saivam, the state, space, powers, being, super consciousness, and Kailasa of Paramashiva. living and radiating the state, space, powers, being, super consciousness and kailasa of Paramashiva. Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. The eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.